So hi everybody, now as we have completed profile feature, square rectangle feature and the circle feature in our previous lectures, so today we will move on to spline. Spline is nothing but a set of curves controlled by control points. So now you can see I had made two points. Now I'll select this point, and as you can see, as I move my cursor and depending upon the positions of the control points, the curve, I'm getting a curve. Okay, so by using this I can draw a shape as I want it to be. So I have drawn a shape. So now the main feature of this spline line is that if when I have drawn my drawing, I can select the control points and I can move and adjust it according to my need. So I can click on it and I can adjust it according to my need. So I can alter or vary or modify the drawing which I had drawn, and I can adjust it according to my requirement. So suppose if I don't want this extra control point, I can select it and I can delete it. Or I don't want this control point, I can select it and I can delete it. So I'll get some less control points. So similarly, I can draw, I can click a point on it, that would give me a point which I can select. The use of this point is I'll elaborate in a much more wider way in the concluding lectures. Okay, so this is spline. So now we'll move on to ellipse. For ellipse we'll require a center point. Now we'll require an major axis, and we have to specify another axis. Okay, so I can specify the axis to be this, and I have created my ellipse. Okay, for hyperbola this we will cover in next lecture set. Okay, line is basically nothing but profile, but profile is a set of continuous line which we can draw continuously from here to here, from here to here. Okay, but line is a command in which we have to draw a line, and then we have to select the line again, means it is a segment of line, segments of line, for which we have to every time select the basic point and the end point, initial point and the end point of the line to draw the line. So suppose I have selected this to be the first point or the start point of the line, this to be the end point of the line. So now again I have to draw the line, I have to select the start point, then end point, then again start point, then end point. But in the case of the profile, I'll just have to mention the end points. End point, the next end point, the next point, the next point. Okay. So this is the line. And even if you want to use certain commands for a long time or multiple time, you can just double click on it at a short interval like this. Now you can see I am in line command. The next time I use the command, for example, if I click on this line one time and I want to draw the line, I have drawn the line. Now I have to again select the line and I have to click on it and I have to draw it. Then again I have to select the line and then I have to click on it and I have to draw that. But to avoid this, I can double click on it at really faster rate, and I can draw the line now, then again clicking in, then okay, so I can draw the line multiple times. So this is the use of clicking multiple times. Okay, I'll just clear the working space so it won't be much of a I've drawn the line. And here are some of the features of the line, infinite line. If when I select the line, it would give me an infinite line which would extend up to where we don't know because it is an infinite line. We'll wherever on the plane we draw, we'll encounter this line when we are drawing it, when we are crossing from horizontal frame, horizontal line. Okay, similarly we can draw an infinite line. Okay, we can draw an infinite line over here. So now we can draw a bi-tangent line. Suppose we have a circle, one is over here and the another is over here, and we want a circle, a line to be tangent to both of these circles. We'll select the first circle and we'll select the second circle. We've got a tangent line. Similarly, we can draw the same tangent like this, and I want the second point to be tangent to this area. We can make a tangent straight, or we can cross tangent it. Okay, so we can create a tangent to two curves or two circles in this way. And the next command is bisecting lines. Suppose if in any case here I have drawn a profile. In this case, this line is bisecting this line and this line. So I can select it. I can select it here. I can select the line. Okay, select this line, and I can select this line. Okay, so I've got a bisector between this line and this line. Now, suppose I want a bisector between this line and this line. I'll get a bisector between this line and this line. So now the third is line normal to curve. Suppose this circle is a curve and I want a line which is normal to the curve. So then I'll select the this point, and I've got a line which would be normal to this, and I can select the extent of this line. I can select this line to be this. Now you can see this line which is generated at this point is perpendicular to the tangent which is drawn to the circle. This line is perpendicular to the tangent which is tangent to this circle, which is ultimately perpendicular to the curve of the circle. In this way we can use this particular command. We have looked at each and every feature of the line command. Okay, we have looked at each and every feature of the line command. Now this is axis system. If you want to select any line which you don't want in your geometry to be used as a feature in our 2D or 3D drawing, we can select that particular line and make it as a send axis. I'll select yes. Now this line is created, and I can use this line only as a reference line, and it won't be created into 3D object, or it won't be considered when I'm using 3D modeling workbench. Okay guys, so next we'll see point feature. Okay, so here's the point feature in profile toolbar. We'll click on it, take out the submenus. Okay, now we have got our point toolbar. We'll place it as per our need. I'll place it over here, and I'll just get rid of those toolbars which are hovering in the space, and I'll just place my. Okay, so for these points I would require some geometries. I'll draw some of the geometries. Okay, and do some work over here, some arbitrary geometries on which I can perform my point commands. Okay, so my first command is point by clicking. This command is very simple to use. You just have to click on the point. Okay, and now you have to select the area wherever you want to place your point. Suppose I want to place my point on this circle, I'll just click on the circle, and my point has been placed. Again, if I want to place a point on the what is of both of these line intersection, I'll just click on it, I have got a point. Okay, so this is basically the function of the first command, which is point. Now we have got another command which is point by using coordinates. First I'll select the point command. I'll select the coordinates I want it at 40 and at 40. I'll press enter, and I've got a point which is at 40 by 40 from the last point which I had selected. It would always create a point which takes reference from the last point which has been created. So suppose if I now create a 40 by 40 point, it would take this as the origin, and now it will create 40 by 40 point from here to here. So let's just see. Okay, and now I've got a point, a new point, which is at a distance of 40 in height and in length from the previous point which was created. Suppose if I create a point again, then I've got a point which is again in a increment of 40 by 40 from the previous point. Okay, now suppose if I want to create point on this particular circle, equidistance points. So I'll click on this equidistance point. This is my third command. I'll click on the circle. I've got an array of points on the periphery of the circle. I'll select the number of points which I want. Suppose I want the number of points to be 12. So suppose if I want 12, and if they are equidistantly placed, then you can assume that they are placed at an angle of 30 degrees. So suppose the angle between these two from the center would be 30 degrees. So I'll just click on OK, and you can see an array of point is created on the periphery of the circle which are at a distance of 30 degree or 25.82 as per the calculation which has been done by the software. Okay, now we have discussed three points. Now we'll move on to the fourth subcommand, which is intersection point. Suppose I want the intersection point of this and this. Now I've got an intersection point of these two 2D entities, which is the circle and the line. This command gives us the intersection of any two entities which intersect each other on a 2D plane, which is a 2D geometry. So suppose I have selected this line, and now I'll select this circle. Now I've got a point which is on the intersection of both of these two figures. Okay, now again in this you can see this line was created. I have got this point as an intersection point. Again I have got an intersection point over here also, because this line and this circle intersects at two different points, and therefore I've got two different points over here. Okay, now the last point which we are going to discuss is the projection point, which I think would be convenient, or you can understand it in a much more broader sense or better way in the future lectures. So we'll skip this particular command for right now, and I think we have completed our profile toolbar completely. Now you can start drawing your basic drawings, basic features in the 2D plane. Okay, so for that purpose you can see links will be provided to you in the below sections, where you can just go and download the worksheets and sample files which would be helpful for you to draw, and basic some basic drawings using profile toolbars. Okay, thank you very much once again from me, Shivam Rai, from Rise Academy. Don't forget to mention your comments. Please share our channel riseacademy.com and help us to make great videos, better videos, finer videos for you all. Thank you very much. Okay.